The theme for today's meditation is Forgotten Woman in the Bible, and the scripture portion is taken from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 4 verses 19 to 22. Bible contains so many characters. Some have been talked about in detail and some were limited to a few verses, and some had only a passing reference, but all had a significant role to play in God's divine plan. In the read passage, we are introduced to a woman who is unnamed. She is known only by her relationship to Eli's son Phinehas. She is seen as a woman with deep piety. She was deeply shocked when she heard about the loss of the Ark of Covenant, which was a symbol of God's divine presence in their midst and their nation. She gave the name Ichabod to her newborn child, which means glory has departed, rather than giving the family name to the child. Few important lessons that we learn from the life of Ichabod's mother are: she respected the godly things, even though her husband did not. Many a times, we find people blaming their life partners or close relatives for the lack of their spiritual fervor. Ichabod's mother is a model for such people. Secondly, she was a very sensitive and pious woman, as she considered the loss of spiritual things more painful than the personal calamity. The loss of her husband was indeed a very heartbreaking incident, but what moved her most was the painful news of the loss of the Ark of Covenant, which was a symbol of divine presence in their midst. We live in a materialistic world where the loss of worldly possessions is considered as more painful. Thirdly, she realized that glory had departed them. Most often we fail to realize when our strength has gone. As we have seen, even Samson was not aware that his strength has departed from him. We need to be vigilant on when spiritual erosions take place in our lives. Fourthly, by naming the child Ichabod, she left a powerful message of challenge for her people to return to God. Her last word was not just a statement of their situation, but a call to rise above it. It reminds us to return back to godly ways. Let us ask ourselves whether the glory of God has left our churches today. Many a times we measure glory by large church structures or big turnouts, but let us ask ourselves whether the real presence of the Lord is experienced in our worship places or not. Even in this context, there is a hope for the people of God. As 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, if the people of God leave their wicked ways and turn back to God with penitence, God will listen to their prayers and will be present for them. Let's pray. Gracious God, help us to have the assurance of your grace and covenant love to face the unexpected traumas of life. Help us, Lord, to build our life on the word of God so that the glory once departed can return to us. Amen.